Thursday night in the streets of Jerusalem's Old City were once again crowded with worshippers, maintaining their boycott of Islam's third holiest site, as long as Israeli-imposed metal detectors remain in place outside it. And once again, as prayer ended, protest took its place. Beyond the Lion's Gate to the Old City, where thousands had gathered, another outbreak of violence. Support for the protesters came from inside the city walls.
I'm optimistic. I believe that victory is close. People have said Jerusalem was sleeping, but now we're waking up. We're coming together.
Victory for the Palestinians means the removal of the detectors, freedom from a measure taken unilaterally by an occupying force. Israel defends it as necessary for security, a response to last Friday's attack in which two security forces members were killed. Authorities released new CCTV images of the incident. Israel's prime minister returned from Europe straight to a security briefing, then a cabinet meeting. He's already admitted to getting different recommendations from different agencies. Police reportedly want the gates to stay put. The General Security Service wants them gone. The concern that with many thousands set to converge on here for Friday prayers, so far limited violence could escalate.
We hold the occupation responsible for any event that happens as a result of the metal detectors and its stubbornness in keeping them, and the humiliation of the Palestinian people.
As Thursday became Friday, the detectors remained in place.
Both sides are all too aware of the consequences of a second consecutive Friday without prayers inside al-Aqsa Mosque, especially given the fact that mosques around East Jerusalem are telling the faithful to come here and pray in their thousands outside this third holiest site in Islam. Time is running out to find a compromise before that happens. Harry Fawcett, Al Jazeera, occupied East Jerusalem.